Well, we have taken scrapbook pages out of the album and we've put them on the wall. And Julie's going to show us how we can actually wear them using a special software.
Yeah, you know, you do all that work and you put all that time into it, and don't you want to show it off to people?
Well, of course,
and talk about
of course.
How proud you are?
Yes.
So what you're going to do, and I'm going to just show you how to use the software here, is you're just going to pick any image. Now, I'm going to work with just a regular image from my computer here, but you would obviously use a layout or any 3D project maybe that you like, or a painting. And you can see here, the image comes into the shape, and over here I have the preview, and you can see that wonderful kaleidoscope. And you can pick out so many different ones from all the choices that you have here, and so many different looks. You can move it around, you can rotate it, you can change the size. And the nice thing that I like about this is I often find a hidden piece of art somewhere in something that I've done. You know, it turns out that something you made looks like a church cathedral window, it turns out. Or look how much like a snowflake that looks. I think it's absolutely gorgeous.
Yeah, I love the previews over on the right because it just shows you what the finished kaleidoscope
picture
is going to look like.
Exactly. Yeah. So what I would do is I would just print that out, and I have some here that I've printed quite small. As you can see.
Very small.
Very small. Now, these ones happen to fit inside this plastic mold here. But I also made some here that I punched with a circle punch. You could use any kind of punch that you wanted or any kind of shape. You can print them out a little larger and punch a part of them. You can make butterfly pendants. That would be beautiful
out of
your kaleidoscopes.
That would be pretty.
All sorts of stuff. And then once you do it, you simply mix two parts together to make a nice resin, an epoxy resin, and you just simply pour it over. And I have these already poured. They've hardened for 16 hours, and I'm going to go ahead and
take them out.
And you can see here.
And all the instructions are with the resin products and things
like that. Absolutely. And you can see a bunch here that I've done. You can make earrings and necklaces. Now here, that beautiful first romantic layout that we looked at, oh my gosh.
That is precious.
Can you imagine being able to wear that wonderful kissing photo around your neck of you and your husband?
A pendant or a brooch.
I think it would be so beautiful. You could do a keychain too, anything like that, you know?
You know what? You could actually attach that to a scrapbook page. It would be a very, very cool
embellishment. Such a fun idea. I like that because actually these little thin ones are kind of like buttons and they are thin enough. You would just take a hand drill and punch a hole in them and you could sew them on just like buttons, which I think would be also
cool.
That
would be very cool.
And I brought here a collection of layouts, and I printed out a couple of kaleidoscopes quite large so you can see the different looks that you get from different combinations. For instance, if you look at the Eiffel Tower hat one, you can see that all that red, black, and white makes for a really graphic set of kaleidoscopes.
That's beautiful. And you know, you've got four different designs there.
Yes.
But they were all done from the same photograph.
Yeah. Very cool.
What about the next? This is
so
my favorite over here.
The bottom one, I love that. Layout is just made from magazine pages and book pages and glitter glue and stuff. And I love how that intense orange changes. And I think it's kind of cool because what a kaleidoscope does is like the word forward is going backwards and forwards and backwards and forwards on it. It gives that really graphic look without really crying out at you. And that one in the upper right definitely looks like a church cathedral window to me.
It really does. Yeah, that's beautiful.
And then I love he's a storyteller because the handwriting on it does magical things. In particular, I really love this one because something about the way that the writing happened created a kind of vine look almost. I feel like those are little white flowers somehow. And that was such a serendipitous, magical thing. And the one right above it, you can see, if you didn't know that that was my brother's shirt, it just looks like almost pretty blue flowers.
Well, you're creating your own unique, magical piece of
art. Yeah, you're taking existing art and making it into new, fabulous art.
Julie, this is brilliant. Thank you so much. You have such great ideas. We'll be right back.